This is GBC Web TV, on the internet at gbcweb.tv. Welcome to Greenford Baptist Church in West London. Here you can watch inspiring biblical teaching and other excellent Christian videos.
Baptized this morning, they will come, they will leave this area up here and go down into this pool. And it symbolizes leaving an old way of life. It symbolizes the fact that they are changing the way that they live. And they come down into this pool, and when we baptize them here, we will immerse them underneath the water. You'll see it on the screen, so don't worry if you're sitting at the back. You'll see all of this, what's going on here, will be up on that big screen. If you can see the screen, you'll see what's going on here. We immerse them underneath the water, and that symbolizes them being buried with Christ. The good news, and I have reassured each of the people being baptized, that we don't leave them underneath the water. We raise them up out of the water, which symbolizes them being united with Christ in his new life. They're sharing Jesus' grave, and then they're sharing his resurrection life. We celebrate today because Jesus is alive. Amen? He's alive today. He's working in our lives today. Amen? Amen? And we celebrate that at Easter. We celebrate that as people come up out of the water and they go out of the pool and they go on to live a new life with Jesus. So baptisms are one of my favorite things in church life because this is spiritual birthday party time. We like birthday parties, don't we? Yeah. Mary, you're not too old to enjoy birthday parties, are you? Not at all. Loves birthday parties. And this is birthday party. But you see, the other thing that I haven't mentioned as we've gone through is that this doesn't just symbolize these things. The Bible is very, very clear that there is a spiritual change, a spiritual transformation, a change in the spiritual dimension that takes place when people are baptized. Because in that baptism, there is a spiritual joining with Christ in his death, a breaking of the power of sin in someone's life, a setting free for them to be able to live the sort of life they want to live in God. And there is, in coming up out of that water, a spiritual joining with Christ. Eternal life doesn't begin when you die. It's not, are you with me, church? It's not pie in the sky when you die. It's steak on the plate while you wait. So we say that again. It's not pie in the sky when you die. It's steak on the plate while you wait. Because eternal life begins when we are born again with Jesus. And we celebrate that life now. It's how we have the Holy Spirit in our lives. It's how we know God's peace now. It's how we know God's joy now. It's how we know God's love in our lives now. Because eternal life has begun in our lives now, today. Amen?
Amen?
That's what baptism is about. And we see the physical and the symbolic, but the spiritual, which of course is eternal, is actually the more real. Because the physical is passing away, but the spiritual is eternal and goes on forever. And that is the most significant component of what takes place in baptism. We have Toyosi. Have you got a fan club?
As a child, I grew up in a Christian household, which included going to church every Sunday. I have been attending Greenford Baptist Church here for a few years and have been a part of the Sunday School, Kingdom Kids and our Ballistic, all of which has helped me to know who Jesus is and the great sacrifice which he did for us all. When I was small and came to church, I assumed it was a thing that everyone did. Wake up on Sunday morning, get ready and off they went to church. However, as I grew up, I saw around me that this is not the case for everyone, as it is not everyone who knows who Jesus is. As I now know how important being in church means for me, it just makes me so grateful that I have had the chance to grow up to know about Jesus and Christianity. When I was younger and I saw baptisms, I thought it was great fun. Seeing a person go in under the water, thankfully not left there, and then brought back up. As I saw more and more, I saw that this was an important step of faith to declare what the individual believed in. In my heart, I knew that would be me being baptized someday, but I thought, let me wait until the timing is right. I had been thinking about baptism in general since the beginning of this year, but then I would end up saying, I'll just wait. Whenever I was asked, so Toyosi, when are you going to get baptized? I was always like, when I'm ready, and that would be the end of that conversation. The last baptismal service here in church was when I felt moved spiritually. And when David mentioned if anyone was thinking of baptism, that they should speak to him or any other leadership member, I knew that was me. The following Monday, I was reading the teenage version of the Word for Today, and the subject of the reading for Sunday 9th of March through to Thursday 13th was Take the Initiative. The message on Monday was what I think most applied. As I read it, it said, nothing happens until you quit holding back. You can't wait for everything to be perfect. You can't wait for your butterflies to go. So you must take the initiative. So today I am being baptized to confirm my faith and begin a new life knowing God the more.
Hey, amen. Well, Toyosi has been coming here all the life that she can remember. Has come through Sunday Club, has come through... In fact, she was born.
No,
four when she came here, okay. So I misheard what you said then. So she came through Sunday school, been through Kingdom Kids, through all the different processes to come to this. But again, you see, it's a way that as you sow seed, our prayers, God's Holy Spirit waters that seed. And in due course, there is harvest for the King. Toyosi, do you confess Jesus Christ as your Saviour and Lord?
I do.
Well, it's a birthday, so you should be happy. Do you turn from sin, renounce evil, and intend to follow Christ?
I do.
And will you seek to live within the fellowship of his church and to serve him in the world?
Yes, I do.
Let's pray for Toyosi now, shall we? And in the coming months and years, you're going to be someone, I just sense God saying, you're going to be someone who is going to be an opinion former. You're going to be someone who's not influenced by the peer group. You're going to be someone who sets the pace for the peer group. You're not going to be somebody who follows the trends of people around you. You're going to be a trend setter as you live your life serving God. You're going to be someone of influence. Influence in people's lives, people in groups of people's lives, and maybe in time even in church leadership. You're going to make a difference for God. Wherever you go, wherever you find yourself, you're going to make a difference for God. God has put that spirit within you, that ministry within you. You're going to make a difference. Father God, I thank you for Toyosi. I thank you for her willingness to step out today. And thank you that this is just the first of many, many times in the coming years. And Father, as we come to baptize her now, as we pray for her in a few moments' time to be filled with your Spirit, Father, I ask there will be a ministry release, a release of ministry gift within her, that she will become all that you have created her to be in the coming months and years. In Jesus' name. Amen. Having heard of your repentance and your faith, we now baptize you, Toyosi,
In the name of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
do hope you've enjoyed and benefited from this presentation. To learn more about what the Bible teaches us and how to apply this to our everyday lives, check out our biblical teaching and other videos at gbcweb.tv. And before you go, an invitation especially for you. Why not visit us at Greenford Baptist Church on the corner of Beechwood Avenue and Ruislip Road in Greenford, West London, the United Kingdom. Our postcode is UB69UA. Our phone number is 020 8575 5034 and our TV website is gbcweb.tv. We look forward to seeing you soon.